Yo, so what's up, guys? We're reviewing the new Air Force One CPFMs.
This is Heel Jack within a sneaker review with your boy Anthony and
Nani.
And we got one of the coolest packs of the summer.
Originally came out in 2020 with the white pair and the black pair,
yeah,
which got re-released now in 2024. And now we're seeing two different colorways, which is the fuchsia color, which we don't have. And we also have this new moss colorway. Starting with the first colorway, which is the new moss colorway. In hand, they are a different type of green.
The mid and the back heel are very bright compared to the rest of the shoe. You could definitely tell with this lighting. It's different from the mid panels. Even the letters have different tones of green, as well as the midsole and outsole. Let's dig into the materials of the shoe.
On the upper part is tumbled leather, which is super nice that they're incorporating a better type of leather. And the obvious part of the CPFM is the big lettering that they have on the sides all the time, which on the right pair has a
air,
and on the left pair it has sunshine running around through the whole shoe.
That's so sick.
And when you flash a light on it, it will give you a nice little like 3M hint on it.
We have a premium sock liner. The back part of the sock liner is leather with a nice fabric material all around the shoe that really makes the shoe comfortable.
The insoles, I do like that it shows like a left and a right one. Of course, you're going to know which one is left.
Just in case you forget.
I think it's really cool. It kind of looks like the weatherman. Like
right. It's like the thermo.
Thermal. There we go.
Yeah. This is very popular in CPFM. You see it a lot in their, you know,
collaborations.
Yeah, there we go. I don't know if it's just me, but I think these have a better quality.
Definitely. I would say these are like the better quality out the three.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's just so... I think they use better leather on it.
Yeah, super nice. And the color so far on these.
All three of these shoes have the same exact box. It's a CPFM box. It's official. The other ones did not come with it.
They came with like the original gray Air Force One box. So you can see this, the Nike logo. It has the CPFM font. And then on the sides, we have those like CPFM designs.
Dude, I love it. Mm-hmm. I think it's probably one of my favorite shoes coming out in the summertime.
Yeah, definitely a summer shoe.
And moving on to the OG ones, which are the re-release of them.
Yes, sir.
The white pair.
And the black pair.
The same as the Moss pair, they do have a CPFM big lettering on the side. Mm-hmm. This one has sunshine, but something that we did find out when we were looking at the shoes, that the black pair,
it says Fleet and Air,
which is pretty sick, dude.
Yeah,
it's the only one out the four. It's crazy to say, because these pairs, I think the original pairs were going about $700 for the white pair, $1,000 for the black, and now we're getting them at $250 to $300.
Yeah, nice resale price on them. I like when they, you know, re-retro shit.
Same thing as well, too. Tumble leather all pretty much all over the panels of the shoes.
Yeah.
And that nice thick lace.
Yeah.
And the same thing with the insoles, we have the same thing.
So this is pretty much copy and paste, or the same as the green or the moss, right? What do you think about these and like some regular Air Force ones?
Dude, honestly, I think it's the hype beast coming in me, but I really just enjoy this shoe. I love the big font on it. I love the tumble leather.
Yeah.
It feels better than the Air Force.
Definitely the quality is better than the regular Air Forces. I love the collabs. This is what I like about, you know, CPFM and Supreme. They do this thing where they come back with just like the plain Air Force One, like white and black. I like that it's a classic look. You know, you can't go wrong with an all white sneaker, an all black sneaker. They just put their little logo on it. I think there's something
wrong.
They
just put a little spin on it. Yeah. And it's definitely a nice summer shoe, dude. Come on, dude.
Yeah.
It's like a beautiful
shoe.
Fire. I'm loving it. Thinking about it now, looking at the box, it has a yin and yang.
Oh, okay.
So I think I would call it like a yin and yang pack, because I feel like I can match, put one on, one foot in one.
This is your pack, right? You bought these?
Yeah. And these are mine, yes.
So you could definitely do that.
That's what I was thinking. Maybe mismatch on them. But
yeah,
definitely this one is beautiful for summertime. That black Air Force is like crazy.
All season long.
All season long, man.
I do like this pack. Like I said, we missed out on the purple ones. Those looked similar to the moss ones as far as like them being different tones of purple.
Yes, definitely.
They also have this the same logo, sunshine and air.
And last but not least, which comes with every single one of them.
Love this
detail. I love it. Now I have three of these, which is kind of crazy. You know what I mean?
Give me one. Look.
Yeah, I might give you one, honestly, because I don't know why I need three, but super cool drawstring that it comes with.
Right.
So it kind of gets a bang for your buck, and it's kind of like a towelish material.
Yes, it's very cool. And what is this meant for? Like to put fuck your shoes in there or what?
I think that's what it is. Maybe for like beach vibes.
Yeah, because the other ones, like the what's it called, Travis ones, at least had a handle. But yeah, this one you put your clothes on. It's like gym stuff for your essentials and shit. Super sick. I love like what they, when they add extra stuff, like it makes your money worth it. Only retailing for $150, that's a good deal.
And resale is not bad, I think.
I know.
Those old pairs used to go for insane prices,
mm-hmm.
and now we get to go back down.
What'd you feel about retroing Covenant sneakers? Do you think it's a good thing or a bad thing?
I think it's a good thing if you don't have them. I think it's a bad thing if you had them and it'll re-release. You know,
because
then
like,
after that it hurts.
Yeah, you know, I already saw the price drops on those. They're down like what, 6-7?
Yes,
something definitely crazy like that. And they're identical, literally. They look just like these. For example, the Supreme Air Forces, when they first dropped, I actually was able to get the first ever Supreme Air Force release.
Yeah,
those were recent for like 300 plus, bro. I remember,
dude,
that.
Yeah.
And now they're coming back to what, like the retail price?
Yeah, pretty much. Just probably like $30 over. Maybe we'll probably see these keep on getting re-retroed.
I love
re-released
that
over and over again.
That'd be sick. There's nothing wrong with that. No. I know. If you really truly love these these sneakers, you buy them again, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
And now that I see the white pair, I feel like the toe box is different from every shoe.
Oh, I see. So it's different tones of whites on that.
Yeah, so not just, I think that's on every shoe. Well, I can't tell on the black pair because it's an all black shoe, but this one you could definitely tell.
And which is cool, you know what I mean? They put their own spin on it and it's super affordable, I think, right now, you know, because, you know, retail for shoes are $200.
Oh, yeah, it's crazy. So what would you rate these 1 out of 10?
Man, I need those Fuyushas or whatever they call that purple pair. That'd be sick to complete the pack, but I think they're all bangers after bangers. I give the whole pack an 8. Okay. I think they did a pretty good job. It's not crazy insane because they're not like insane colors and shit, except for like the purple and the green ones.
Yeah.
But definitely a nice staple to wear. You know what I mean? A super cool shoe just to have.
I'm leaning towards a 7 on the pack. I feel like this is a nice adaptation of the Air Force Ones. I love that it was minimal like change, just a big ass font on it.
Yeah.
I just love it.
Which one is your favorite out the pack?
The one I'm holding, bro. This is the bear. So this is the one I believe that doesn't have any 3M on it because of the white border.
Yes.
Bro, but that's the sickest part of this shit. Like, it's always, it just makes, okay, it just changes the whole shoe. If it was all black, I would have been like, it's an all black shoe.
It's but, you know what I mean? It's just some criminal activity ones.
Exactly.
But this one is like a hype beast criminal activity one, which is kind of cool.
The other ones you'd be scheming, but this one you'd be like really doing some
you'd be doing some crazy shit.
An awesome shoe, but what's your favorite out the pack?
I think definitely, I thought it was going to be the green one, but I'm really loving these white ones.
So sick.
The white ones just go with everything. Of course, you need an all white sneaker no matter what. Let us know which one is your favorite out the pack. Let us know if you guys are going to cop or not. And then make sure to go down in the description. We have our social media pages down there. We have our TikTok, Instagram. We also have our personals on there. Give us a message, comment, and let us know what you guys think.
This has been another sneaker review with Heel Drag. Thank you guys for listening. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you guys on the next one.
Peace. Better quality leather. Quality. They incorporated a better quality. Damn it. They incorporated a better quality. There we go.
Sorry.
God damn. And obviously the difference of it is cactus plant flea market. There we go. And they always the obvious.
You just say CPFM.
The lettering does have 3M on the back. So you flash your light on that. You flash your light on it. God damn, I'm fucking up.